Corey Stovall, I'm Zan's son and Desi's grandson, and all y'all have brought up how special Laura was and an awesome mother, and I think Desi emulated exactly that. And she used to tell me stories about her mother, and but this, what I wanted to bring up was Donnie, and he hadn't been mentioned yet. He was a very, very impactful to me, and all my uncles have been. But he, when he was in the hospital, I'd gone to visit him, and he was laying there with his eyes closed. And I walked in the room, and I was a little intimidated. I thought, well, I don't want to wake him up, because I don't know if he's tired. And I walked in there, but his sheets were off, and he looked cold. And I started pulling his sheets up, and just how Donnie always said it, he was like, well, what you doing, boy? And he said, what you doing, boy? And I said, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wake you. He goes, oh, you weren't waking me. I knew you was in here the whole time. I just had the rest of my eyes. And anyway, I planned on just going in and getting out, but we wound up sitting there and talking for a few hours, and we brought up a story. And I know all y'all, through all Donnie's trials and tribulations in his life, know how hard he worked. Well, in 1984, I'd taken a job at United Supermarket, and my mother had just moved to Lubbock, and I didn't want to go. I didn't want to leave Littlefield. It was March of 84, so she let me stay behind to finish my freshman year at high school. Well, to bribe me, every week she had a stereo or a wait list. She's got to come to Lubbock. Well, she finally got me, because she got me a Mustang. And so I'd taken this job, and I decided, well, I can drive now. I'm going to go visit Donnie on 58th Street. Which wound up being the biggest mistake I'd ever made, because I pulled up there, and he's like, ooh, let me look at that car. And I was so proud. I said, well, I just washed it. And he goes, did you? And I said, yes, sir. And he goes, well, let's look and see if you really did. And that man could wash a vehicle, because we raised the hood, we raised the trunk lid, we opened the doors, we cleaned inside where the door got grease on it, and it took almost 6 hours to clean that car. And so at that moment, I was never gonna ever go over there again in that car. So he called me up. Actually, I was at home. He called me, and he said he was having this garage sale, I guess to raise money for AA, or I wasn't quite sure. And he said, how's that car look? And I said, oh, it looks good. It's really real shiny. He said, well, guess what? I was really impressed how you helped me that day. My truck needs a good cleaning. So I got cornered and went back over there. And from that point forward, I told my boss at United I could work every Saturday. That's all I have.
I didn't know my dad was related to Donald.